We're back here at the GSL Grand Finals Team League. It has just been an exciting series so far. Very evenly matched, but it's not done yet. We got a ZVZ coming up here. Don't get to cast many circular shirts. And it looks like, in a way, I may have played a perfect chess game thus far, in the sense that they managed to get a Protoss out. Now, that Protoss, of course, they got the Terrence. Then they pick out July, because July, of course, can hold that thought. We'll never know what I'm going to say. The countdown started. There's no time. Enjoy the next game here at Zerg vs. Zerg in the finals of the GSL Team League. Get ready. Our first Zerg player from the Team Startale.
July Zerg.
And in the blue at the bottom left, our other Zerg player.
I am Lucida.
Now, July Zerg in Zerg F1 was a beast in Zerg vs. Zerg. In Zerg F2, it seems to be his weakest matchup.
Yeah.
So Lucira's intentionally been sent out here, Lucira being a very strong Zerg Berserker, sent out here to take on his opponent.
Well, you know, he gets a practice with IMNST. We're going to have to see if enough of that has rubbed off to take out someone who's probably quite a legend to him. Both of them being StarCraft 1 pros. Now, there's something interesting going on here behind the scenes. The way that ZVZ has been played thus far in StarCraft 2, a lot of it's based upon the map size. Now, this map is pretty long. As far as I can tell, the distance is longer than Zelnaga, and it also has some high ground areas in the middle. So we may see it played a little bit differently than normal. Maybe not, but it's going to be harder to actually walk across the map with any roaches. Looks like, you know, there's some extra paths, there's these high ground areas, and so we're going to have to see how that goes. Lucira already taking his expand. July Zerg, on the other hand, going for the quicker pool.
Well, this is going to be interesting. July Zerg's done some risky stuff in some of the previous Zerg Berserks we've seen. And miscontrolled it. You know, it's funny because July Zerg's control was so good in StarCraft 1. In StarCraft 2, he's had some disasters occur.
Yeah.
Particularly in this matchup.
He has that.
You know, controlling Banelings, totally different game from controlling Mutas in StarCraft 1.
But I'm sure he'll get there. He's one of these guys that even in StarCraft 1 at first, everyone's like, well, he's really fast, but he's terrible. What's going on? And then suddenly, after he had the July Zerg number of games that he needed, he became like the greatest Zerg for years upon years. So looks like he's going to do a very aggressive build, Tasteless. Speed and getting a Baneling Nest already. Whereas Lucira just now getting his Roach Warren.
Now on this map, I mean, the way it's set up, it's kind of tough to defend.
Yeah.
The main and the natural expansion while having the ramp covered.
Yeah, that's exactly it, Tasteless. And that's going to make July Zerg's build pretty viable, because even if you get roaches out, normally to defend the natural, you want to just jot down, hit the lings that are hitting your hatch, and jot right back up your ramp, because you can't get surrounded or you're going to lose. Here, I don't know if Lucira can do that. You know, the natural is just kind of off to the side, and he's going to have a hard time with that. Now, July Zerg is making a couple Banelings way off to the side. If he can hit the Zerglings of Lucira, then the Roaches won't do that good a job, because they definitely do need some Zergling backup right now.
Uh-oh! Flank! Oh, nice!
And those two Banelings not being used as well as July Zerg would have hoped. He's now given away his strategy quite heavily as well. He's already investing in Banelings.
Here he comes off the ramp.
And oh, a little bit of a surround going on. And it looks like Lucira should be able to fight this group off, but might lose a couple roaches. Oh, only loses one.
Oh, my God, that one. If he can move that roach to the back.
Yeah, if Lucira moves that roach to the back, sits on his ramp, just keeps pumping. he's going to be in a pretty good spot right now. Supply-wise, 36 against just 25 from July Zerg. And 16 drones for Lucero, whereas July Zerg has 14. 7 Roaches and 2 Lings against 16 Lings.
Not even mining Vespian gas, if you guys didn't notice.
Yeah, in fact,
so
he's going
like,
to go ahead and expand.
Catch-up time.
And the Overlord's even going to see that. Huh. So July Zerg trying to expand from here. Lucira obviously with a big advantage.
You know, it's funny, as July Zerg seems almost at times unable to play conservatively in Zerg vs. Zerg because of his StarCraft 1 history.
He's entirely too aggressive at times.
I mean, Zerg vs. Zerg in StarCraft 1 was like Warcraft 3 on crack on the fast forward. It was just all micro.
With no hit points.
With no hit points.
July Zerg.
And in this case, StarCraft 2, it's not really the case.
No, it's changed.
It's changed matchup.
You can't just kill someone with better micro in Zerg vs. Zerg in this game. You have to use a lot of strategy in it. You have to really be very careful with how you do it. Now, Lucira, what's he going to do? He's made more drones, so he's up to 20 drones against 13 from July Zerg. July Zerg has shown the expansion, but sent off the Overlord that was scouting it with his queen, and he just continues to make Zerglings. So it looks like July Zerg's simply going to all in again.
Well, to be honest,
and you got
to
watch out because this many oh man, beautiful, moves back the roaches in the back so that they don't take that splash damage. And he's going to have to just keep his roaches on the ramp. That was awesome. What July Zerg wanted to do was deal a lot of splash to all the roaches so he could plow through them. Not working out for him, though. A couple roaches coming out to poke, to prod, moving back on the creep, being very, very careful right now.
Look at that control. Now, if July Zerg can get this hatchery, that would be something else. You see, he wants him to pull all the roaches down there, but Lucira is too smart. He says, no, keeps him at the ramp, because then otherwise he's going to send the roaches up into the main. But more roaches have now been produced, which means he has more room to keep that area secured.
You know, Lucira right now just keeps making roaches. He wants that critical mass of roaches. Another option also would be, you know, just make a baneling nest and go all in if he kills your hatch. We'll have to see, though. It looks like he has more than enough. The dry Zerglings going for broke, and they're not going to be able to break that. He should have been able to see that.
Uh-oh. And Lucira says, now it's my turn.
July Zerg definitely going to run around and counter.
I can just imagine July Zerg's queen going, what's that sound? It's rumble, 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 rumble. It's
more
all
like
of
scuffle,
those
scuffle,
roaches.
Scuffle,
scuffle, scuffle, scuffle, scuffle. Yeah, roaches don't rumble. They scuffle across the ground.
Ultra scuffle.
It's so many roaches.
It is. It may be too many for July Zerg. He is popping out a ton of Zerglings right now. Really, he needs to clump these. Very nice. Clump them back to the minerals if you can. Just try to not let the Lings get too much surface area on you. More and more Zerglings flood out from July Zerg. A lot of Zerglings
Actually.
On the way from Lucira as well, though. And the thing is, Lucira has 25 drones against the 13 of July Zerg. So even if July were to take these out, Lucira can just reinforce with anything he wants. And Lucira's Zerglings are on the way, Tasteless. I cannot see July Zerg holding on through this
well,
wave of Zerglings.
Well, he's going to lose the queen in about 1 second.
Even more roaches join the battle. GG.
GG.
And July Zerg's all-ins. Once again, Balaam in a ZBZ. Really, that is by far his weakest matchup, Tasteless. Which
he
is
did it.
Just so interesting because he was so good at it in StarCraft 1. But that was a good snipe. That was a good snipe by IM. A good choice. I don't think Lucira was originally planned. And what's he going to do?
What's he going to do? Oh, damn.
Ooh.
Oh, damn.
I just spilled coffee on my nose.
I saw that.
Yeah. That's how excited I got there. I almost dropped my drink. I can't believe you did that to them. Did Bomber just get out of his chair? Bomber was just out of his chair. What are you doing, Bomber? I wonder if you're going next.
What are you doing, Bomber? You crazy guy. I am. It's so good.
Lucira, very happy with himself, as he should be. Doing his part. It's now 3-2 for IM. Isn't it, Tasis? Look how closely they're talking to Bomber. I wonder who they're going to send out.
It'd be so funny, everybody's talking to Bomber, and then they just send some other person. I'm like, what? What are you guys talking about between these games? So, could
just
be
like,
Bomber.
Oh, did you see the new episode last night of our
favorite? Have you seen Lost? Like, I'm like, not now,
not
man.
The time.
It's the finals.
It's not the time.
So, it looks like they probably will send out Bomber. Now, Bomber, We haven't seen this guy, and there's a reason for that. Everybody is talking about how this guy is so solid.
Probably saving him for last, but might be saving him for here.
Well, my bet is that they think the last player that's going to be pulled out will probably be MVP, and they might have some kind of strat set up.
They might be saving Ace.
They might be saving Ace for MVP.
I think that's probably what it is. Ace showed us some of the best, most solid PBTs I've ever seen at the pro level. And so he definitely could be saved as the MVP sniper.
Bomber is just supposed to keep taking out players until MVP is the last player put out. Game genie, Taren. That's my bet.
My bet
that's
as
the way
well.
I feel. You can never take that away from me. All right?
I'd make you feel different.
Okay, who's it going to be? Wait for it.
It's got to be Bomber. He's so tricky.
And Bomber.
It's going to be Bomber. It's time, everybody. I know everyone at home is wiggling. Keep wiggling.
Your computer desk is shaking back and forth. It's getting so awesome.
That's right. Don't spill anything on your keyboard.
Oh, Bomber's saying they're going down.
Well, can Bomber do it? He is so hyped. I don't know what to expect.
You know, it's funny because the TSL coach even specifically said, I think we can win this, but we're going to have to figure out a way to get rid of Bomber.
You know, he was a great StarCraft 1 player. Yeah. Great Taren in StarCraft 1. I've heard nothing but good things in StarCraft 2.
Man.
We'll be seeing
momentarily. Oh, man.
Lucira is no joke. Yeah. He is no joke. The kid knows how to play.
Imagine drinking beer out of that bad boy.
Wow, that is so unelegant of you.
You had to have two hands and something to chip in his teeth. Just on it.
It'd be all sharp. It'd be terrible. It'd be heavy. Someone has to help you. They pour it too quick. Someone goes in your nose. You're like,
it's terrible. Now, there's not much time left. We're just waiting for Bomber to get his keyboard and mouse plugged in and get his settings proper. And all right, the jacket's coming off.
Nope.
Yep. It's getting hot in here. So take off your IM jersey. No. Thank you for that charity giggle. Lost Temple.
All right. It's a good map. Tank drops used to be all the rage here. Now, the only build you'll ever see in the GSL is two barracks outside your expansion. So expect that opening from Bomber. And from Lucira, we will see. He is a very strong player, probably a hatchery first. Good drone micro into a spine crawler. That's my prediction.
The countdown has begun. Let's see what this Bomber guy is all about.